Good morning, Antioch. It is a pleasure to be with you today by digital. It is an honor and a pleasure that I take in speaking with you or having a look deeper into the Word of God. My name is Evelyn Creighton. I'm one of your teachers here at Antioch. The title of today's lesson is A Vision of Restoration, A Return to Joy. God promises justice. Today we're looking into the book of Zephaniah. Zephaniah has three chapters only. I'd like to encourage each of us, or each of you, to please go into the Word of God and read the background of chapters 1 and chapter 2. Now, in chapter 1, Zephaniah addresses the woe, what is to come or what is happening to the children of Israel because of their disobedience. In chapter 2, Zephaniah is addressing the issue of repentance, what the children of Israel need to do to come back to God. And in today's lesson, Zephaniah chapter 3 is looking at a vision of restoration, the return to joy, God's promises of justice. The key verse today is, "Behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that halted and gather her that was driven out. And I will get them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame." That's Zephaniah 3, verse 19. If you look at this key verse, Zephaniah is looking to the future to let the Israelites know that their future looks bright. If I had to add to today's title, I would say what is titled in the young people's lesson, "In the End, You're Gonna Win," or "Justice Wins the Day." This lets us know that God will restore. He'll give us beauty for ashes. Now, who's being addressed in today's lesson? Zephaniah the prophet is the first person, and of course, God is the center of this lesson. Zephaniah addresses the nations, Jerusalem, and the whole of Jerusalem. Zephaniah's name means preserved. God has preserved. Zephaniah is a descendant of Hezekiah. It is speculated that Zephaniah is the great-grandson of Hezekiah, and he's a Cushite, saying that it's a part of Ethiopia. When does this lesson take place? It takes place during the reign of King Josiah. In chapter 1, as I said, chapter 1, Zephaniah addresses woe, judgment. And in chapter 2, Zephaniah talks about repentance. The kingdom of God is at hand. The great day of the Lord is coming. But then he lets the children of Israel know that the great day of the Lord is coming because of their disobedience and the choices that they have made. The children of Israel were kind of looking at things like, if you can't lick them, join them. The children who were sent to harass the children of Israel, as was addressed in the book of Habakkuk prophesied to the children of Israel, and the children of Israel said, "Now, Zechariah, something's not right about that. Those people that God is sending to chastise us are even more evil than we are." But today, Zechariah reminds them, all you have to do is repent, and God will restore you back to your rightful place with him, according to the covenant that he made with Abraham. Now, Zephaniah kind of talks about woe. He talks about judgment. But in today's lesson, he talks about a better day is ahead. I like to think about what's happening to us today with the COVID-19. We have to stick with God and not act as the children of Israel did in their day, where they trusted God, but they didn't truly trust him. And because of that, they joined in with the children who were sent to chastise them. And God said to them, he said to them through the prophet Zephaniah, that you, because of your disobedience, you're being chastised by a heathen nation, and they are worse than you are. But Zephaniah says in chapter 3, that there's a better day ahead. Now, why is Zephaniah prophesying to these people of Israel? Because they were God's chosen people, and he wanted them to know that even though they had sinned, that God was going to restore them. He was going to commute their sentence. He's prophesying because the children of Israel have started to worship the idol gods along with those people who were there to chastise them. Zephaniah presents both judgment against wickedness and injustice of the whole of Jerusalem against the priests, the judges, and all of the national leaders. Israel, as I said, didn't trust God totally, but they needed to repent. Jerusalem was vulnerable, and they were in need of protection. But the vision of restoration was at hand. Zephaniah told them that there will be a time to rejoice. Comfort will come to Israel after the catastrophe. He said that they will be able to live without fear. They can once again praise God for salvation, for the stopping of their enemies. He follows the prophet Amos, and if you'll recall, several Sundays ago we studied about Amos, and Amos was talking about the injustices that was perpetrated on the children of Israel, and the children of Israel was perpetrating injustice. And Amos pleaded with them to let justice roll down like a mighty stream. And in today's lesson, the prophet Zephaniah is following up with good news through the prophet Isaiah. Isaiah tells them, and I believe it's chapter 61, that God is going to restore them and he's going to give them beauty for their ashes. Today's lesson, as I said, is a lesson of restoration. He's preaching that their sentence has been commuted. The sentence has been lifted. The future looked bright for Israel. There's no longer a need to fear. Let's look at today's lesson. Today's lesson comes from chapter 3, verses 14 through 20. And in verse 14 through 15, let's just focus on a couple of key points. Sing, O daughter of Zion, shout, O Israel, be glad and rejoice with all the heart, O daughter of Jerusalem. The people are told to sing. Zephaniah says that there is a view to salvation. There can be a view to salvation. There, a better day is coming. He tells the children of Israel, or the daughters of Israel, the daughters of Jerusalem, he tells them to sing, to shout, be glad, and rejoice. That is the 14th verse in chapter 3. And let's look at some key points in the 15th verse. In the 15th verse, it says, the Lord had taken away thy judgment. He hath cast out thine enemy. The king of Israel, even the Lord, is in the midst of thee. Thou shalt not see evil anymore. In this particular verse, the prophet is pointing out that God has pardoned them from thine enemy. God has pardoned them from the captivity that they have survived for over 70 years, and they will not see evil anymore. Let me stop here. I have committed one of the things that we never do in our Sunday school class. I did not stop and pray. So Lord God, in the name of your son Jesus, we just ask that you will please grant us your Holy Spirit. Help us to understand the word and to impart the word to you and to the people of God as you would have us to do. Lord God, I ask that you'll forgive me for jumping into the lesson without asking your grace and your mercy. I'm a little nervous, and you know, because you made me. I'm asking, Lord God, that you'll bless, keep us, and help us to understand the word that Zephaniah is saying in this lesson. Thank you, Lord. We pray these blessings in the name of your son, Jesus. Amen. Now, let us go on with the 16th verse. In that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, fear thou not, and to Zion, let not thine hands be slack. In this particular verse, the prophet Zephaniah is saying to the children of Israel, Jerusalem, very comforting command. This is a command. Don't let your hands be doing anything that is wicked. When the Lord God comes, let not thine hands be slack. In other words, be about the business. Some of the children say, don't talk about it, be about it. So let's be about God's business. This is what Zephaniah is saying to the children of Israel. And in that 17th and 18th verse, I kind of combined these two because this is about God's promises of a better day. Now, in this particular 17th and 18th, this verse says, I will gather them that are sorrowful for the solemn assembly, who are of thee, to whom the approach of it was a burden. Now, in here, God is saying to the children of Israel to rejoice. He was saying God is going to join the children of Israel, as was in the 14th verse, Zephaniah told the children of Israel to pray, to sing, and rejoice. But in this particular part of the scripture, Zephaniah is saying to the children of Israel, God is going to join you in singing and rejoicing. This is the kind of God we serve. When we're disobedient, he's going to chastise us, and he whips us kind of hard. But then on the end of that chastisement, we can rejoice because God is going to be with us. He's going to sing. He will sing over you with joy. In this verse, as I mentioned, it's just incongruent with the 14th verse where the children of Israel were to sing and rejoice. But now God is going to join in with them as they sing and rejoice. Now in this 19th verse, let's look at what he says. And I love this part because he says, I will. And when God says, I will, you can count on that. If our friends say, I will, it's a maybe. He says in this 19th verse, behold, at that time I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that halted, and gather her that was driven out. And I will get them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame. In other words, God is not only going to restore the children of Israel back to their original state, which is a part of the covenant that he made with Abraham. But not only is he going to restore them, he's going to give them a name above all names, and everybody going to know who they are because they are his children. And in this particular one, I just love, it just gives me cold chills to think about, he's going to give us beauty for ashes. When we go through suffering, and a lot of it is because of the choices that we have made, we go through suffering, God is going to restore us. He's going to deal with our enemies, and he's going to give us a name so everybody going to recognize that we are children of the living God. God is going to fight our battle. And Habakkuk told them that, you know, those people, we understand that they are worse than you are, but God's going to restore you. And as a matter of fact, he's going to raise you above where you are now, and he's going to give you a name that everybody's going to recognize. Fame will be given back to them. Now in this 20th verse, at that time will I bring again, there it is, I will bring again, and even in the time that I gather you, for I will make you a name and praise among all people of the earth, when I turn back your captivity before your eyes, saith the Lord. There it is, I will bring you all back home. I will make your name great. This is Lord God talking now. I will have praise among you. I will gather you all. I will restore your fortune. And he's going to do that before the eyes of many. God is going to restore Israel back to its original plan that he had for them through the covenant that he made with Abraham. Something else that we might want to notice that goes with verse 19, when God works in us, it's big. When God works in us, it's clear. When God works in us, it's a good thing. Now, in summary of today's lesson, this is a time to rejoice. In the end, you will win. We will be able to celebrate. The children of Israel will be able to celebrate. And if we think about what's going on today, in the end, we're going to win. We will be able to celebrate. Justice will reign. God is king. He is a warrior. He's going to protect us, and he's going to rescue us. He is strong. This is what Zephaniah is saying to the children of Israel. He is strong, and he's speaking to us today. Now, let's don't take the Old Testament as if, oh, that was back then. God is speaking to us today through his word and through his prophets. He's strong. There's no need to fear. I know we're scared, because we're human, but we don't have to really fear. We fear God, and we want to stay and hold to God because he's the one, he's the king. and he said to us to be not afraid. He will make everyone to know your name. This was a part of the covenant that he promised Abraham. To Judah and Israel, they had been scattered, but they would be gathered home again. They were in captivity for 70 years. He said, Zephaniah saying to them, disaster has passed. Your sentence has been commuted. He said, there will be peace. He said to them to rejoice and praise God. We need to keep in mind that God is the righteous judge. And when we're talking about judgment, we're talking about justice. Know that God is the righteous judge. He is merciful. Israel will be restored. When God works, it's big, it's clear, it's good, and it's just. We need to keep in mind in today what we're facing is that God loves us. And he forgives us, even though we sin. He forgives us, and he forgives our past. Don't look back at our wrongdoings. Let's not look back at our wrongdoing. God forgives us if we ask for forgiveness and we repent. Thank the Lord that God is gracious and he's merciful. He will forgive us and he will restore us back to our rightful place with him. We can rejoice in the presence of the virus. We can rejoice in the presence of our enemies. We need to remember to stay in our homes and follow the orders of Caesar, the order of the government, and especially our public health officials. We can rejoice like the children of Israel. We can sing praises. We can sing to our God. We need not have any fear. And remember, we don't need to look back because we're not going in that direction. Thank you. God bless you, and may he keep us in his grace. Lord God, we just thank you. We love you, and we praise you. We thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity that the superintendent and the assistant superintendent have given to us to review the lesson. We ask, Lord God, that you bless this nation, bless our Congress, bless our state leaders, our local leaders, and Lord God, bless the churches that are calling on your name today. Lord God, we ask a special blessing for our Antioch Baptist Church family. Bless those and keep us in your prayers and in your good graces. We thank you, Lord. We love you and we praise you. In the name of your son, Jesus, we pray. Amen.